Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied that there are three types of matter, that is solid, liquid and gas, and now we are purposely talking about the gaseous state only. So now let us see what are the measurable properties of the particular gas. So before understanding what are the measurable properties of gas, let me tell you that gas is something property which has no intermolecular force of attraction, or they have less intermolecular force of attraction, because of which we are now going to learn few properties which is based for only gases. The first one is especially mass. Mass is something which we can calculate for solid as well as liquid, but yes, we could calculate for the gaseous also. The next one is for volume, the next is temperature, the fourth is pressure, fifth is density, and the last is diffusion, and this diffusion is related to the gaseous only. So now let us learn each one by one and let us see what are the properties of this mass, volume, temperature, pressure, density and diffusion. So now talking about the first property, that is mass. So gas molecules have characteristic mass which is extremely small, because gas molecules, because they are very light molecules and hence they have weight, but that weight is comparatively very much less than the overall molecules of the gas. So therefore the mass of one mole of a gas molecule represents the molar mass of that particular gas molecule. So the mass is expressed in gram. So the molar mass, it depends on the molar mass also, because the molar mass is something which is related to weight and the molecular weight. So the molar mass for a particular gas will be equals to, that is, if one mole of a particular gas, if it contains 6.022 × 10⁻²³ particles of that particular gas, so that would be the molar mass of that particular substance. So what we have to do is we have to multiply a single weight of a particle of a gas, and we have to multiply by the Avogadro number, so that would let us to give the molar mass of the overall particular gas molecule. So this is the first thing that we have learned, that the gas has a property of mass. Also we could also calculate the mass, and the mass is always and usually calculated in grams, because it is being very negligible. We can't measure the gas in more quantity. We can, but usually it is expressed in grams. Now talking about the next one, that is volume. So a gas occupies entire volume available to it. So this is what I want to explain, that suppose if in a room which is a very huge room, and if you insert a gas molecules in it, few gas molecules in it, so that gas molecules will occupy the overall space that is being present in the room, or it will occupy the whole volume of that room. So this is the property of the gases, and yes, they follow to cover the entire room's volume. Hence, the volume of the gas is equal to the volume of the container in which it is being stored. So that particular gas, suppose if it is kept in a particular volume, so the overall volume of the gas will be equal to the volume of the container in which it is being kept. So that is the thing of property of a gas, but it is not okay with that of liquid. Why? Because in liquid, as you know, that liquid will only occupy the shape of that container and will occupy volume, but not as gas, because liquid settles down while gas doesn't settles down. It spreads in the atmosphere, or it spreads in the container equally, and hence making the volume of the gas equal to that of the container. So the volume is measured in cm cube, or basically dm cube. So dm cube, that is liters. So this is how the volume of the gas has a particular unit, that is cm cube and dm cube. So these are the two properties that we have mentioned right now, that is for mass and for volume. Let us move on towards the next one, that is temperature. So The temperature is measured for a gas, basically. The temperature is measure of a energy associated with a gaseous system and indicates the degree of hotness or coldness. So temperature is what where we could measure if, whether a particular thing is hot or cold. So by measuring that temperature, we could predict that it has been hot or cold, or the energy that has been associated with it. So if there is more energy, we could say that it is more hot. If it is less energy, then we could say that it is cool. Very much less energy, then we could say it is cool. So it is, the temperature is related to the energy of that particular gaseous system which is associated with that system. Now talking about the next one, that is the temperature is measured in degree Celsius, in degree Fahrenheit and Kelvin. Usually the SI unit of the temperature has been said to be Kelvin, but yes, there are three measurable quantities or properties where we could measure, that is degree Celsius, degree Fahrenheit and Kelvin. So as we know that for Kelvin and for degree, we know the relationship as suppose if we want to convert 1 degree Celsius into Kelvin, so what we have to do is we have to add 273 with that one that we have 1 degree, so ultimately we'll get 274 Kelvin. So there is a very direct relationship that we can convert a degree Celsius into Kelvin by adding 273 with that degree Celsius that we have. So by this we could convert in Kelvin. But talking about the next Fahrenheit, then the relationship between temperature unit, they both are related with each other, that is the degree Celsius and Fahrenheit, the both are having a relationship like this way, that is if you want to convert a particular degree Celsius into Fahrenheit, then what is you have, that is degree Celsius divided by 5, which is equals to degree Fahrenheit minus 32 divided by 9. So this gives a relationship between degree Celsius and Fahrenheit. So the temperature are for a particular gas are been measured in these three quantities, that is these three factors, that is degree Celsius, Fahrenheit and Kelvin. Now moving towards the next one, that is pressure. So pressure is also a kind of property of a particular of any gas that we usually measure. So the first one is the pressure of a gas is the force exerted by the gas molecules per unit area on the walls of the container. So gas is basically some a kind of state where we know that it is a state of matter which doesn't have a particular size or shape, but yes, it occupies the shape of the container. And most of all, this particles, they don't have intermolecular force of attraction. So what happens is they are very free with each other and they have a very long distance with each other. So therefore they collide with each other, these molecules collide with each other and they collide in a random motion. So making this molecules to exert pressure on the walls of the container in which it has been kept. So as the pressure will be more, then it will try to have a pressure on the wall of the container more, or if we would say that if the number of particles of the gas are more, then the more kind of pressure would be exerted on the walls of the container, because the more the molecules, then the more the random motion, more the random motion, more the kinetic energy, and hence the pressure will go on increasing if we increase the number of molecules in a fixed amount of or in a fixed volume of a container. So now talking about the next, that is the pressure is measured by barometer or mercury manometer and expressed in terms of height of mercury, that is Hg, mercury is denoted by Hg, mercury column, that is cm of Hg. So let me tell you a short example that how can we measure or how can we convert the pressure from a manometer to a atmosphere, or that we know, that is we know that 1 atmosphere is nothing but something related to 760 mmHg. So 760 mmHg is basically the height of the mercury which occupies when the vapor pressure is basically 1 atmosphere of a particular liquid or of a particular gas. So we also know that, so this is been measured, this atmospheric pressure is been measured with the unit of mmHg. So talking about the next one is they have also other units like Newton per meter square. So this 1 atmosphere is nothing but 1.013 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per meter square, or basically we could also say it as 1.013 into 10 raised to 5 Pascal. So this is one atmosphere. So we could also measure that is property of a gas in terms of the pressure also. So the more the number of gas, so that will exert more the pressure, and hence this is the one atmosphere pressure that the atmosphere in which we live, that is, it has a common pressure of 760 mmHg. But talking about the when it comes to high pressure, means the more the pressure means more the value of this 760. So this will create a high pressure, and high pressure, which means it will contain more number of molecules and they will collide with each other, and they have less kinetic energy also will be more in that case if the temperature is been increased in a fixed amount of volume. So this is these are the few properties that we have learned right now. But there are two properties that are also been remaining, that is density. So now talking about that. So basically, density of a gas is the ratio of mass and its volume. So we know that it's a very common thing that we know that density is nothing but the ratio of mass and volumes. But we could also determine the density of a gas by calculating its mass and the volume that has been occupied by that gas molecules. So the SI unit, it is expressed as kg per meter cube. So but it depends on pressure and temperature also. So that is what I was expressing. So it depends on pressure, it depends on temperature, and because of that, it will also depends on the volume, and because of which it has been the mass. It's fine that the mass, we could calculate the mass, but it also depends on the volume also. And that volume will depend on pressure and temperature, and because of that, the density will be related to each other with that. We could determine what would be the density of a particular gas. So yes, the density of a gas varies appreciably with change in pressure and temperature. This is what I want to explain. Suppose if pressure is being increased or keeping the volume to be constant, so what will happen is if pressure is being increased, then the force of attraction between the two molecules will be more, and the more the force of attraction between the two molecules, that means they will come together with each other, and this will lead to us know that the density of that particular gas will be more. And yes, the more the pressure, the more the dense is the gas. And talking about the next one, that is temperature. If we increase the temperature, suppose what happens? If we increase the temperature, then the gas particles, they collide with each other and they try to spread. And if they try to spread, and what happens is, suppose the number of mass will be the same, but the thing is, they won't be condensed with each other and they won't be close to each other, and yes, the density will go on decreasing. But what happens is, when we have a fixed volume and we increase the temperature, so in that case, what happens is, actually, if we increase the temperature, then the volume tries to expand. So in that case also, by keeping the pressure as constant, so we could say that the volume is fixed and the temperature is been increasing. So in that case, the collision will be more, and hence the pressure will be also been set to be more. So therefore, in that case, basically the density can also be more. And basically, we also could say that if the volume of the gas is very much less, then we could say that the density of the gas is more, because the density depends on the mass and volume. The lesser the volume it occupies, the more is the density, and the more the mass, the more is the density. So volume should be very much less so as to determine whether the particular gas is highly dense or not. And if temperature increases, and suppose the pressure has been set constant, what happens is the volume increases. So if the volume increases, then what happens if the volume increases, density goes on decreasing. So it depends on pressure and temperature, and from that only we could determine the density of a particular gas. Now talking about the last one, that is diffusion. So what is diffusion actually? So the process of mixing of two or more gas to form homogeneous gas mixture is called as diffusion. So diffusion is only related to gaseous molecules, because what happens is when the two gaseous molecules, they mix with each other, so they mix in a homogeneous type. So because they are mixing in a homogeneous type, we cannot separate it, and this kind of process of mixing two kind of gas molecules, or the same gas molecules with each other, same kind of gas molecule with each other, if you would say. So what happens is they try to diffuse with each other. This term is just for the gas, and it is not only for two molecules, two types of gas molecules. We could introduce more gas molecules also. It is a very logical thing because air is itself a component which consists of carbon dioxide, oxygen, nitrogen dioxide, various gas. So basically in this case, diffusion always happens. So because the two gas or two or more gases, they combine with each other. In factories, like in chemical factories, the smoke that has been produced, so it gets diffuses in the overall air, and we could see the smoke because the smoke at that point is very much dense. And what happens is, if it spreads, then it spreads the entire environment, and we could see that the density get decreases because the volume has been more. And because of that, what happens is the diffusion takes place because they mix with every gas that are been around them, and they form a homogeneous mixture. Yes, but yes, the more thing also, that the rate of diffusion depends on the molar mass of the gas. So they are being related to each other in this way, where the rate of diffusion is equals to volume of the gas diffused divided by the time required for the diffusion. The more, the less time required to get diffused in a particular volume, means higher is the rate of diffusion. The more the speed of getting mixed with the environment or getting mixed in a volume of a gas, so more will be the rate of diffusion. So for example, in volcano eruptions also, what happens is the smoke gets erupted, and we could see the density. So that doesn't homogeneously mix with the environment. Actually, we could see the dense smoke or the gases that produces there. So at that point, what happens is the rate of diffusion is less, but we could increase that also by increasing the volume. If the volume is more, so at that point we could see that the rate of diffusion is also more, because it depends on the volume of gas diffused. If the volume is more, then the rate of diffusion will also be more. And yes, if it requires less time to get diffused, then also we could see that the rate of diffusion is also more. So the unit is nothing but the cm cube per second. That is the unit of, because volume has a unit of cm cube, while that of the time has a unit of second. So this is the unit of diffusion. So this is where the few properties where we have went in a very thorough manner, and we have understood each and every concept of the properties of the gases. So thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have got to know various concepts. And share this video with your friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.